Doki Doki Literature Club Plus, the standalone extension to the hit game Doki Doki Literature Club, adds so much new content and many new secrets, including sketches for game development and promotional material. And what better time is there to go over these secrets than right now? Alright, everyone. My name is Echo Tango, and welcome to the second part of a four-part series detailing all of the secrets DDLC Plus has to offer. In this part, I will focus on everything regarding the 20 sketches and 9 promos you can unlock throughout the game. Before we get started, I recommend you play DDLC Plus at least once before watching the rest of this video, because there are spoilers ahead. Now with that out of the way, let's get started. The first sketch is one of the easiest to get. During any poem minigame, choose the phrase Doki Doki, and you'll see a concept sketch of the complete cast, drawn by Kagefumi, who was one of the first artists for Team Salvato. This sketch is quite fitting because the game is called Doki Doki Literature Club, after all. To get the second sketch, try both Sayori and Monika, in any order, for weekend help before choosing Natsuki or Yuri in Act 1. You'll see key art by Kagefumi of Sayori and Monika, which was originally planned to be official artwork. Notice that the art directly models the sprites of Sayori and Monika on the title screen. To get the third sketch, delete Monika's character file before starting a new game. You'll know you did this right when Sayori immediately appears to you when you start a new game and says, "What is this?" and "Please make it stop." The game will automatically close and a concept sketch of Sayori by Kagefumi is yours. As a bonus, if you open the game again, you'll be greeted with an end screen followed by a black and white screen with Sayori's dead body, accompanied with creepy static. As an additional bonus, wait 10 minutes and you'll see the message, "Now everyone can be happy," in Sayori's handwriting. To get the 4th, 6th, and 9th sketches, write perfect poems for Natsuki, Sayori, and Yuri respectively in Act 1, and you'll be rewarded with sketches of their first CGs before they were outlined and colored in. To get the 5th sketch, write all 3 poems for Natsuki in Act 1, and you'll see concept sketches of Natsuki's second CG. Team Salvato notes that due to the scene's lack of realism and general absurdity, it was a challenge to get Natsuki's angle correct, especially in perspective alignment with the background. To get the 7th sketch, write all 3 poems for Sayori in Act 1, and you'll see a sketch of Sayori's second CG cut out and aligned with the angle of the background. Team Salvato notes that since the background was first rendered in 3D, some fine adjustments were made so that the 2D drawing of Sayori would fit seamlessly into the perspective of the scene. To get the 8th sketch, attempt to load a save file after Sayori's death. You'll be notified that you won't be able to, and thus Act 2 starts automatically. You'll then receive a sketch of Sayori's 3rd CG. Team Salvato notes that this was eventually mirrored, making it one of the only instances Sayori's bow is on the other side of her head. Also notice that Sayori is wearing her school uniform in the sketch, while she is wearing her casual clothes in the final CG. To get the 10th sketch, write all 3 poems for Yuri in Act 1 and you'll be rewarded with a sketch of her second CG before it was outlined and colored in. To get the 11th sketch, delete Monika's character file before she begins any of her monologues. This can best be done right after you read her poem, Happy End, and before the text box disappears for the first time. If you are successful, you'll see a concept sketch of Monika's only CG in Act 3. To get the 12th sketch, achieve about 65-70% game completion or data completion. You will receive an email from LibMoozy titled, Character Discrepancy. With that email is a rough concept sketch of what the faceless protagonist might have looked like if he was a real character. I will go into more detail about the emails in the future part of this series. To get the 13th and 14th sketches, obtain the special ending of the story. To do so, see all the character CGs, which will require making saves when necessary. You'll know you did this right when you see Dan Salvato's message of gratitude at the very end of the game. You'll then be rewarded with a sketch of the DDLC chibis used in the poem minigame, as well as a collection of the character's original sketches before being outlined and colored in. Notice that Natsuki's head angle was later changed to make her pose more natural and candid, rather than model-like. To get the 15th sketch, press the skip button while Monika is talking in Act 3. Notice that Monika will notice you trying to skip and disable the button entirely for the remainder of the act, and even in that act in future games. You'll be rewarded with a color sketch of Monika's initial character design, drawn by David Evelyn, a college friend of Dan Salvato who worked on the original game characters back in 2016. To get the 16th sketch, choose to call Sayori for help during Natsuki and Yuri's argument in Act 1. You'll see a sketch of Sayori's initial character design, drawn by David Evelyn. To get the 17th sketch, choose to tell Sayori that you would still walk home with her at the end of the second day of poem sharing in Act 1. you'll see a sketch page by David Evelyn to test and compare different hairstyles for Sayori. Notice that a few sketches depict Sayori with longer hair, which reminds me of when Sayori told Yuri in the second side story that she used to have longer hair, but she cut it because it was hard to maintain. To get the 18th sketch, review the file poemwords.txt for any anomalies. In other words, go into the game folder under the Files tab and open the poemwords.txt file. Scroll down until you see the line 915130 under Yuri's winning words. Close the file and you'll receive a concept sketch of the complete cast drawn by David Evelyn. Regarding the anomaly, I will discuss it further in a future part of this series. To get the 19th sketch, experience Natsuki's Play With Me scene, which requires writing both poems for Natsuki in Act 2 before the second day of poem sharing. If you did all this correctly, you'll receive an unusual poem for Natsuki, as well as the following gameplay footage. You'll then receive a character sheet of Natsuki's original design, drawn by David Evelyn. Oh, and about Natsuki's unusual poem, it is written in Base 64, which when put through a decoder with new lines removed, reads the following. Open your third eye. I can feel the tenderness of her skin through the knife, as if it were an extension of my sense of touch. My body nearly convulses. There's something incredibly faint, deep down, that screams to resist this uncontrollable pleasure. But I can already tell that I'm being pushed over the edge. I can't stop myself. To get the 20th and final sketch, select the corrupt word during the poem minigame during Act 2. If you do, the minigame screen will change drastically. You will then receive a sketch page by David Evelyn which tests and compares different uniform styles. Also during the change poem minigame, you will have the chance to hear a baa. Take a listen. Yeah, cute, but unsettling. Now on to the promos. To get the first three promos, write a poem for a different character each day in Act 1. One combination would be Sayori on Day 1, Yuri on Day 2, and Natsuki on Day 3. These promos celebrated Valentine's Day in 2018 and were all drawn by Satchely, who designed the characters of the game as we know them today. In fact, Satchely drew all promos you get to obtain. To get the fourth promo, listen to at least 15 of Monika's monologues during Act 3. You'll know when you have done so when you receive the achievement, She Will Never Be Real. Just like the last three promos, this promo celebrated Valentine's Day in 2018, but this time placed a significant detail on Monika. Notice Sayori, Natsuki, and Yuri in the background. To get the fifth promo, acquire all the special poems from Act 2. Since every game randomly chooses three special poems, you'll need to play the game multiple times. Unlike the rest of Satchely's work, this promo has never been shared since she drew it in 2018. I will go into more detail about the special poems in a future part of this series. To get the sixth promo, make it through the entire weekend in Act 2 without pressing the skip button. This could be best achieved by repeatedly attempting to quit to main menu, which will instead fast forward the weekend from daylight to dusk to night to daylight again. This promo depicts Monika and Yuri having a sleepover, drawn in 2018. Notice the title of the book Yuri is holding, Famous Words from the Famous Warning Message. To get the 7th promo, finish all the side stories, including the bonus side story, Equals. This promo celebrated Monika's birthday, September 22nd, in 2019. To get the 8th promo, choose the word Horror during any poem minigame. This promo celebrated Halloween in 2019. To get the 9th and final promo, delete Monika for the second time. You'll know you did this correctly when you receive the achievement, Two Stalked. This promo celebrated Monika's birthday in 2020 and is fitting of what 2020 was defined for, the COVID-19 pandemic. And so, that is that. Now I want to hear what you guys think. What did you think about these sketches and promos? Which were your favorite? What were other interesting facts about them that I didn't cover? Let me know down in the comments below. Now with all this being said, I'd like to say thank you for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, drop a like down below, lets me know how I'm doing. And if you want to see more of my content, why not hit the subscribe button? How about me and how about you? So once again, thank you all, and until next time, I'll see you around.